Do you need to enter credit card related transactions? Well, stick around because in this video, we're going to demonstrate how to enter each of the different types of credit card transactions. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. In our first example, we're going to put in these two charges. And when we put them into QuickBooks Online, we're going to use the expense window to record these charges. Let's focus first on May 10th. Charged a repair from Rex Repair Shop for $1,000. We charged it with the Capital One credit card, and this was the number on the slip. Well, it's very simple. We go to the Expenses tab, click Expenses. Now, when you click New Transaction, the new expense is what you choose. And when the expense window comes up, you come from the payment account pull down and you actually choose the credit card that you're charging the expense to. In this case, the vendor who gets the money is Rex Repair Shop. Let's just double check that. Yep, $1,000, transaction 11223344, whatever. Okay, so this is Rex Repair Shop, and we know that the payment date was May 10th, and in our little story, we're doing May 10th of 2017. Now, because we're paying Rex, it means the service that we're paying for is repair expense. So the money is coming from the Capital One credit card to paying repair expense, and the amount is $1,000. Okay, that means when we finish, repair expense goes up by $1,000 and the Capital One credit card will show up for the first time in the trial balance as a balance of $1,000. Save and close. Let's go back to the reports, take a look at the trial balance, and you can see for the very first time Capital One credit card now has a balance of $1,000. You should also notice that in repair expense, if you double click repair expense and scroll to the bottom, you can see that this credit card charge was recorded as an expense to Rex Repair Shop, and you can see the payment account or the split was not the bank account and not petty cash. It was paid from Capital One credit card. The second transaction, May 11th, charged supplies from Staples, $2,000, with this big long transaction number, whatever it is. So we go like this, expenses, then of course, new transaction. The type is expense if it's a credit card charge. And this time we're paying Staples. And we are paying from the Capital One credit card. Now, the day that we charge this to Staples is May 11th of 2017, and the expense or the asset in this case that we're buying is supplies. I guess you could put it as supplies expense or supplies depending on how the company runs. But the amount is $2,000. And what I forgot to put in the reference number field is the big, long, crazy number that's usually on the credit card, 9988776. Yeah, you should probably put that number in, 9988776. There you go. And this is how you fill out a credit card charge in the expense window. Okay, now save and close. And now when we look at the reports and we look at the trial balance, you can see Capital One credit card has now a balance up to $3,000. That includes both of the charges, both to Rex and to Staples. And of course, supplies expense, if you double click and go down, it'll show this expense. This is the credit card charge that just increased your supplies expense that you charged from your Capital One credit card. Now, let's enter a credit card credit and a credit card payment. And remember, for each of these types of transactions, you use the specific windows provided by QuickBooks Online. So for example, May 12th, Rex gave us $100 credit back on the Capital One credit card for the May 10th repair. Well, you may notice that up here, you have a specific window specifically under the vendor pulldown for credit card credit. Open it up and just follow the prompts. Okay? The payee is Rex Repair because they're the ones giving the credit. They're the ones we charged before. Here we have the Capital One credit card as the account where the money is going back to. You have to put the date that Rex gave us the credit, and the exact same expense on the charge is the exact same expense on the credit. Now, the credit amount was for $100. And of course, there's usually some long, weird, blathery number that goes along with the transaction for the transaction number. So of course, you would type that in. And then basically, that's it. All you would have to click at this point is in the bottom right. You might not be able to see it, but we filled it out properly. Click Save and Close. And now, when we go back to the trial balance, you can see that the credit card balance has decreased by the $100 that we just got the credit for, and the repair expense also decreased because we had $100 less of repair expense because we just got a credit for the charge for repair. Now, what about this? May 13th, paid Capital One $200 with check number 900 just to decrease the credit card balance. Now, we know if we pay 900, this balance goes down to 2,000 even, and this becomes 30,000 something because the bank balance is also going to decrease. In the plus sign menu for new transaction, there is now in QuickBooks Online a specific window to pay down the credit card. You choose the credit card that you're paying down, you put the amount, in this case 900, and of course the date of the payment was May 13th of 2017, and the bank account is cash in bank. I made the payment with a check, and the check number is 900. You cannot make a mistake in this window. Simply fill out the form the way it asks, and you are unlikely to make one of the common mistakes discussed in the previous video. Click Save and Close, and now you can see the credit card balance properly went down to 2,000, and the bank account changed accordingly.